Hello YouTube. Today I'm going to be showing you how to get a higher rating as a free to play. As you guys can see, I have 21k rating. And yes, I'm not fully free to play, but I haven't even spent more than like 50 bucks on this game. I'm tired of seeing free to players who's level 55 getting like 10k ratings, and you could get basically way more than that. I'm going to show you guys how to do that today. So, first step y'all want to do is head on to your leaderboard, go to rating, just find somebody who's pretty high rating, and you guys can compare your rating with them. So you guys can see equipment basics, mine is 5.4k. He has like 400 more, so I need to work on that. 4k, as you can see, 6k. This is kind of pay to win, so I can't really work on that. This, everybody should have max, really. It's so easy to get. This, I need to work on. This is pay to win, but I mean, free to play could get it, but it's pretty hard. You need a lot of gold. This is pretty balanced. This, I need to work on a lot, but again, pay to win, can't really go up above that. This, I have maxed. This is pretty close as well. So if you guys go into your own profile, you can improve anything you want here. So, camp training. I basically maxed this out. To get these points, just do your dailies and always look for it like this level. Daily supplies and regular supplier. These give you a lot of camp points. And this. And just, you know, participate in camp events, especially a daily bonfire. For talent points, again, dailies, and then ravens, right here. Stronghold challenges give you a lot of fucking talent points, and then you can also do hold the line. And there's Astro Tower, which I don't fucking know where it is. Right here. So this also gives you talent points, and yeah, just every single daily. You guys have to do dailies, they give you points. Drone it's important for basically your rating. So I'm using this one, which gives me 1,500 rating. This one will only give me 700. So if I put this in fight mode, my rating goes down by a lot. And then if I put this one back, it gives me a whole 800 something rating. So make sure to craft your drones, the newest part that you can. So yeah, get your ratings up. So for equipment skill, I have 0 because this shit is fucking hard to get. You can do like Raven, finals, camp, competition and stuff to get them. But I don't think I'm gonna grind these. If I do, I'm probably grinding the purple ones. I only have a couple. They sell for, I don't know, sometimes they sell, sometimes they don't. You can get the cheapest one for like 20k, but you need like 50 of those. So if you stack those up, that's a lot of fucking gold. So these are your mods. You can basically craft them and then get your stats, but the higher the stats, of course, more the rating. You can modify them, just you need this. I'm not grinding these, so it's not worrying me that much. Here comes the farm parts, polishing. Again, pay to win. But if you guys look down here, it says next level, 7 pieces of equipment, polishing, plus 15 on higher. Progress is 5 out of 5 because I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if I do these 3, I'll get an extra max HP, damage, and armor piercing. So make sure you level these up instead of just going for random shit, making them random ass levels. Now enhancements. I swear to God, if you guys don't have these max, I don't know what to fucking tell you. These are so easy to get. Literally, you get them from your dailies, and I even sell them because I have too much. I sell them for coupons. You get like 150 a day. These are so easy to get. So last but not least is the equipment. Again, pay to win, blueprints. If you're free to play, just the reinforcements, make sure these are always the same level. So progress is 15. And I need like what, 3 more to be leveled. So I need to work on, let's see. What the fuck? Okay, I need to work on this, this, and this, and then I'll get the extra stats. So a few more ratings is your expertise. This is up to you which expertise you want, but of course max get the ones with the damage reduction or damage increase for PvP purposes. On my end, I don't know about PvE. I don't usually do PvE. So if you guys go into the MG shop, here you can get blueprints. Yeah, don't buy these, I saw those. Armor, and I usually only max silicon and blueprints out every day because I don't have enough for every single thing in the market. And I save those just so I can get these every single week or every single day. Another thing of rating is your role. I think this is the only one that gives you rating, but scavenger. And if you upgrade these, they increase damage. This one increase critical, and then these also gives you rating. Yeah. So there's these things called what, enhanced syringes that you can grind. Some of them you can't grind like 30k rating yet. We can't grind that yet. But if you can grind most of them right now, and these give you permanent stats. So max HE by 13, damage 2, and skill rating by 2. And I think it gives you 15 rating. So if you stack them up, then they give you a lot. I think you can, yeah, you can also get them exploration. So go explore some fucking maps. You can get 3 of these at Redwood. And then 2, and then 1 here, I think. And then max energy boost, also buy these. These also give you rating. I don't know how, but it just does. So, yeah. A few things you guys might not know is if you go into the gold, you can buy talent points. I think you can buy 10 of these or 5 of these a week. And then last but not least, there's this. So if you go into perks, mystery shop. These out, let it load. You can also buy these, and yes, it says RC, but if you wait for the refresh, sometimes there's options that you can buy with gold, and sometimes they give you like armor plates for gold, which is so useful. So make sure you check this shop every single day. It refreshes every 24 hours. Thank you guys for watching. If I missed anything, just leave a comment down below. Help each other out. Yeah, thank you.